Here, we are going to solve a minimization problem using geometry. So the problem goes something like this, that maybe inspired by the Pentagon, the headquarters of US Department of Defense, the Department of Mathematics decided to build their own headquarters called the triangle. So as the name suggests, the triangle has three wings, and within these three wings, there is a nice lawn over here. And the mathematicians working in these three wings can access this lawn using the gates that are provided. So there are three gates, one gate each for each of the wings. And then these gates are connected by a walkway. And then it was decided to minimize the length of this walkway so that the mathematicians don't waste their time walking between the buildings, but inside the buildings collaborating with each other. So that's the problem definition. Here we have a triangle represented by the lawn itself, and inscribed within that is another triangle, the walkway, whose perimeter is to be minimized. Now this problem was first considered and solved by Fagnano, so it is known after him. So let us have some numerical values. So we'll have the length of these buildings as 96, 80 and 64, say. So in general, a scalene triangle. Then we'll simplify the problem by getting rid of the buildings, because all we need is this triangle. Then we'll remove the walkway, because that is something we have yet to be found. And then we will assume that somehow we have figured out the gate positions here and the gate position here, and the third gate is to be worked out. So in that case, we'll have this kind of situation. We have fixed those two gates, and then the third gate we are working out. Suppose the length of these two walkways coming here is currently 80. So let's see whether that length is optimized or not. For that, I'm going to keep the length constant and just move it around like this. And immediately I realize that that length is too much, because it is not only taking me to the building, but it is taking me beyond it as well. So I'm using too much of the walkway length. And interestingly, the point here seems to be tracing a curve. Now, what could that curve be? Well, if you have two fixed points and a definite length of a string, you get an ellipse. And therefore, this point is tracing an ellipse. So let's kind of reduce this ellipse, shorten this ellipse, okay, by changing this length. So instead of, say, 80, I'm going to make it, say, 75. Okay, and then again, let us see what kind of ellipse we get. Well, it is not overshooting as much, but it is still going beyond it. So let's reduce it even further. So let's make it, say, 70, and we try again. And this time, yes, the ellipse is just brushing against the wing where we want to reach. In other words, it is tangential to the base of this triangle. So that's the trick. If we want to minimize this pathway, then we have to find an ellipse whose foci are the other two gates, and which is tangent to the third wing. And that point of tangency will be the position of the gate. So this is the property of ellipse that is going to come handy here. It says that the tangent to an ellipse is equally inclined. These two angles are equal to these two lines, which are connecting the point of tangency to the two foci. So here, this is the tangent to an ellipse whose foci are A and B. PR is the tangent to an ellipse whose foci are B and C, and so on. So we can mark these angles as equal. So these two are equal angles, equal and equal angles. Let's name them something as, say, alpha, beta and gamma. And that gives us the angles of the triangle that we are seeking. So this angle must be 180 minus 2 alpha. This must be 180 minus 2 beta, and this must be 180 minus 2 gamma. So let's write those equations over here. And if we add them up, these three angles, they must add up to 180. So we can get a relation for alpha, beta, gamma as alpha plus beta plus gamma is equal to 180. Now that is interesting. If alpha plus beta plus gamma is 180, then this angle must be gamma. By the same token, this must be alpha and this must be beta. So let's mark those. This gives us three similar triangles like this, which are similar to each other as well as the outer one, because all the triangles now have angles alpha, beta and gamma. So if PQR are the sides of the outer triangle, then we can say some scale factors x, y and z for these three triangles. And then their lengths can be written in terms of the outer triangle lengths, PQR, like this. So x times p, x times q, x times r. Similarly here it will be y times p, q and r. It will be z times p, q and r here. And that gives us three equations. This p is made up of xq plus zr. Similarly, we can write expressions for these two. So we got three equations here. And the unknowns are the scale factors x, y and z. Solving, we get an expression for this x. And it is looking like the cosine rule. If you look at this angle r, then it is q square plus p square, adjacent side squared and added, minus r square, so opposite sides square subtracted, divided by 2 times the product of pq, the adjacent sides. And therefore, this must be cos of this angle r or beta. So we can write this length as rc, this rc can be written as rp into cos beta. So it is this whole length into cos of beta. But this is possible only in a right angle triangle like this. So, and this right angle triangle to be formed needs this line PC to be perpendicular to RQ. But such a perpendicular is nothing but altitude. So that gives us the position of this C. Where is C located, or where is the gate of this building or this wing located? It is at the foot of the altitude dropped from here. By symmetry, even A and B will be the feet of altitudes dropped on those respective sides. Now, a triangle which connects the 3 feet of perpendiculars of a triangle is called as the orthic triangle. So here is our walkway, the so-called orthic triangle. And to find its perimeter, let's just keep the relevant details and write the scale factors that we are getting for these three triangles, just like this x turned out to be cos of r. Here they are. And that gives us an expression for the perimeter. And it's beautifully symmetric. The perimeter is p, this side, multiplied by cos of p, the angle opposite here. Q into cos of q, so this into cosine of angle here, and r here multiplied by cosine of this angle. So in words, the perimeter of orthic triangle is the sum of all three sides multiplied by the cosine of angle opposite to them. And here is the numerical data that we had. The length of the wings were 96, 80 and 64. When we substitute these angles, we get the cosines and the final perimeter turns out to be 105 units.